We are very excited to have been here today for this very special event, the launch of KPMG Cyprus Audit Committee Institute, an institution which is addressed to audit committee members and non-executive directors alike. Capitalizing on the pool of knowledge of KPMG Cyprus partners, our specialized departments, and with the support of KPMG International Network, we have the ambition to become the point of reference for audit committee members here in Cyprus. We would like them to appreciate the benefits of joining us and gain access to the abundance of relevant KPMG publication and resources, and also being informed of current issues that should go on their agenda. Matters that have to do with the developments in Cyprus, the EU, the world in general. Matters like the EU audit reform, cyber security, corporate culture, legal and regulatory requirements. We are confident that soon KPMG Cyprus Audit Committee Institute will become an important link to the global chain of KPMG Audit Committee Institutes around the globe, which currently expands in over 40 countries.
Understanding audit committee members' needs will be achieved through interviews, our surveys, and obtaining feedback from the audit teams and the regulators. This information will enable us to generate responses that are timely to the Cyprus reality. Our Global Audit Committee Handbook is a crown jewel publication of the Institute, and we are very happy that it is now available to the Cypriot Non-Executive Director. A must-read handbook for all the audit committee members, the internal audit, and others dealing with audit committees. Additionally, we have set our website, which runs on the external website of KPMG, and will serve as a library for uploading all of our tools and publications. The objective of the Institute is to update and refresh the skills of our Cypriot non-executive directors, and we are certain that it will be a point of reference for the years to come.
It's been a great honour to be here this afternoon for the very first Cypriot Audit Committee Institute event. It's been a very interesting series of conversations and debates. I myself talked about my experiences running the Audit Committee Institute in the UK and the audit committee journey I have been on. I've looked at some of the audit committee practices that have changed over the last 15 or 20 years. I've looked into the future at some of the things that we're likely to see change, and I've discussed the fundamentals, the building blocks that are essential for all audit committees, whether here in Cyprus, in the UK or the US or anywhere else.
We have launched today the KPMG Cyprus Audit Committee Institute, whose main aim is to help our clients fulfill their roles and responsibilities under the new provisions and legislations. The KPMG Cyprus Audit Committee Institute is a full member of the Global Audit Committee Institute, which consists of 40 countries around the world. We had the pleasure today to have with us Mr. Timothy Copnell, the leader of the Global Audit Committee Institute, who shared with participants his valuable experiences and knowledge. The KPMG Cyprus Audit Committee Institute's role is to help audit committees and help them navigate through the challenges they are facing and they will be facing in the near future. Another aim of KPMG and the Audit Committee Institute is to empower and enhance the corporate governance in our country.
This was an extremely successful event. The KPMG Audit Committee Institute focuses on very, very important matters that are relevant both to the board level but also the audit committees of organizations. Cybersecurity is one of those important subjects. Globally, the threat landscape is evolving, the threats are increasing, and the organizations have to make sure that they have a strategy in place, both accepted at the board level but also monitored and enforced by the audit committees. KPMG is a global leader in information security and cybersecurity defense and can help the organizations formulate this strategy but also implement the various actions that need to be implemented for the organization to stay secure.
In my capacity as an accountant who has served the accountancy profession for 37 years, I strongly believe, that the recent EU guidelines, directives as they are commonly used to be called, on the subject of corporate governance, and in particular on the new elevated and enhanced role that audit committees have to play, the new directives, I would use a strong word, I believe they will serve, and I am hopeful they will serve, as a catalyst, a real catalyst, in achieving, in elevating the role and the participation on an active basis rather than on a backseat basis. That has been in many cases the experience of the past in elevating corporate governance to the envisaged levels of potential investors and authorities. I remain confident that the recent impetus and momentum that has been gained both globally, I would say, but as well as in our little island of Cyprus, will show the fruit and the yield of this effort, which will appear very shortly in the annual reports of listed and perhaps private companies in Cyprus, not only abroad, as well as in their various announcements, which I consider to be critical in portraying the correct messages to investors, which must be and they ought to be fully aligned to the actual operational performance of their entities.